Good morning, students. In the last lecture, we have started our new lesson, that is air around us. Okay, so in this lesson, what we discussed before, so whatever the points, air, the composition of air, means which components are present in the air, how much percent it is, and what are the uses of that all. Okay, means we have discussed about the oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide and other gases. So now the next point, it is some activities are given in your textbook. Okay, so for that, the first point, see what it is, the presence of air in water. Okay, means in the water, air is present. How to prove that? For that activity, it is given in your textbook. See, first we will discuss about this, means what is this air around us. In this one, air is in a water. See, do you know that the aquatic animals, okay, means those are living in a water, that all animals are known as aquatic animals. So these aquatic animals are living things, okay, and you know that all the living things need oxygen to breathe, means for respiration process they need oxygen. Now they are living in a water, then how they are getting the oxygen? Because oxygen is dissolved in a water. Okay, means what? In a water, oxygen is present, means in the water, air is present. So aquatic animals easily breathe in a water. Okay, so for that, very simple activity, it is given in your textbook. What it is, in one beaker, see, it's a very simple, you just open your textbook, in that it is given. See, this is one beaker, and in the beaker, this little amount of water we have to take it, okay, and just start heating this water. What you have to do, start heating. When you start heating, on that time, okay, you will see a small bubbles comes out. Okay, it is not a boiling process. When from a starting, when you will start heat, you will see the small bubbles comes out, and that bubbles means what? The air, whichever the air present in the water, that air comes out, means while heating, when we started heating, the solubility of air in the water is decreases. Okay, see here I written one sentence, when water is heated, the solubility of air in it decreases. Now solubility of air means what? Soluble means what? It is completely dissolved in water, it is mixed in water, that is known as a solubility of air. Okay, so when we start heating, when we start heating, what happened? The solubility of air is decreases. So see here, when we started heating, the first time when started heating, when this water, so a small amount of the bubbles comes out, means what? The air comes out. So it proves that air present in a water. Okay, so for that, this activity, it is given in your textbook. So do you understand how the air is present in air and why it is important for us? Okay, so then see the next point, as a result, the air dissolved in water comes out in the form of tiny bubbles. Okay, so already I have explained you here, so read this activity carefully and see this picture also, it is given in your textbook. Okay, so now the presence of air in water, this point is completed. Now next point we will see, that is presence of air in soil. See, air is everywhere. Okay, so in our surrounding air is there, that we can know with the help of, means we are feeling that air is present here. So now we have discussed about the presence of air in water, and the next point, that is presence of air in a soil. Now see, in the soil also air is a present. See, some animals, those are living in a soil, inside the soil, like earthworm. Okay, do you know earthworm? Earthworm is also a living thing. Earthworm also need oxygen to breathe. Okay, plants roots are taking oxygen from soil, means the air is present in a soil also. Okay, so because of that, the oxygen plants get, and what the earthworm, okay, earthworm also get the oxygen. See, when you saw the earthworm, mostly in a rainy season, earthworm comes out. Why only in the rainy season it comes out? Because the water goes into the soil, means whenever the air present in the soil, in between the soil particles, it comes out and water takes the place of that air. So the earthworms not get enough oxygen to breathe. So because of that, earthworm comes out in the rainy season. Okay, so for that, to prove that air is present in the soil, one activity it is given in your textbook. Okay, so that activity now we will perform here. See, in this beaker soil is there, okay, dry soil, and this activity, simple activity, you can do at home also. In this beaker dry soil, this is one empty beaker and this is water. See, now I use the word this is empty beaker, but actually it is empty, no, because why? Air is present in this. Okay, so now we will perform the activity. What we have to do, see this dry soil we have to add in this. Are you able to see this? Okay, now observe carefully. When I will add water in this, small bubbles will come out. Means what? Water will take a place of air and air will come out. Okay, you have to observe it properly. See, now I am adding slowly water in this. See here the bubbles comes out, means what? Air coming outside. Okay, so it proves that, see this simple activity, this activity you can do at home also. Okay, the small tiny bubbles comes out. See here you can see how the bubbles comes. So it shows that air is present in the soil. This activity also you have to do at home. Okay, means you can see properly, you can observe it properly and write this observation in your textbook. Okay, now the next point that we will continue in our next lecture. So today we will stop here. Today your homework is write these points in your chemistry notebook. Read this lesson, complete whole lesson you have to read it, and whatever the important points that you write in your chemistry notebook. Okay, if you have any doubt regarding this, all the points, you can ask me. So today we will stop here. Thank you.